started out when I was 20, and our home farm we bought in 2004, and then we bought this place in 2013, and we just keep trying to add to it as we go. So when you're done for the day, you can step back and see what you've done, and it's rewarding to see that part of it.
Today we're here at the Caldwell Farm in Guernsey County, and we're going to be talking about NRCS programs and some of the best management practices that he has implemented here at the farm.
This was the only thing I really wanted to do. I wanted a concrete feed pad, and I wanted some cost share dollars on that. And then once we got started talking, Jay came out and looked, and we went over some other areas, and he had a lot of good ideas that we implemented that I hadn't even thought about.
We have the heavy use pad that we're standing on today. We have an access road that attaches onto the heavy use pad. We have two different watering systems on this farm. We have a well. We have a pressurized water system off of a spring development that goes into a 1500 gallon storage tank and then is pumped to different areas on the in the pasture fields. From water quality, soil erosion, compaction, also from an economic viable standpoint for Ty's operation is how do we make this farm more profitable based on the number of animals that we have.
I can see a difference in the cows through the winter, and then as in addition, when we start calving in the spring, you know, when cows are wading in and their udders are in mud, manure, it was unhealthy for the calves and I had a lot more scour problems. Since I've started feeding on this, it's reduced that almost down to nothing. You hear people talking about it, but I never really seen it for myself. And then until I seen it and actually used it myself, then it made a believer out of me.
It's a very financially based program. It helps spread the producer's dollars out farther. So if say that fence is a dollar a foot and we provide 75% of that dollar, that spreads their money out even farther and able to do more conservation programs that, down the road.
So 86% was covered by the EQIP program, and then the rest of it was out of mine. So, you know, and I guess with that being said, it allowed me to do a lot more than what I would have normally done because my money went farther. So I would highly recommend other people looking into this.